Students, now we shall start revising the lesson Disaster Management. What is disaster? Disaster means the sudden calamity occurring into your surrounding is called as disaster. For example, earthquakes, floods, storms, forest fires, and there are so many more types of disasters. But in this year, we are studying only few types of disasters. How do disaster occur? Disaster occurs due to the irresponsiveness of human being. It happens because of pollution, mining, building of roads, building of dams, terrorism, and different types of situations present on earth. Let's study now different disasters, some types of disasters. First one is earthquake. What is earthquake? What have we studied under the point earthquake? Earthquake is the cracking of earth. Now why does it happen? Simply earth cannot crack, no? Yes. Earthquakes occur due to shaking of earth, and that is why there are cracks present on the surface of the earth. Floods. Flood means when the absorption of earth of water level stops due to heavy rainfall, and the water level on the earth's surface increases time to time, and because of that, all things present in your surrounding, present in your homes, flow. That results into flood. Storms are when the heavy wind flows. Because of that, what happens? Sometimes trees break down, buildings break down. That is storm. And forest fires, we all know. Forest fires are the fires taking place in the forest. Recently, last year, there was a situation of forest fire in the Amazon rainforest. Have you seen in the pictures? So many children must have seen on internet. The forest of Amazon rainforest was fired. Forest fires occurs due to irresponsiveness of human beings. Sometimes due to lightning, thundering also forest can take fire. That is the natural calamity. But sometimes we human beings also are irresponsive towards the forest. What people do? They come for their enjoyment in the forest, in the gardens, and they throw away the cigarettes, they throw away the matchboxes, and due to that, forest can take fires. Disaster management. Now, to control this above situations like earthquake, floods, storms, forest fires, some or the other person has to take initiative, right? To bring the situations into control. Not the 100% of the situation, but at least a little part, a little help people can do for one another, to give a support, to give hand of sharing. That is the disaster management. There are committees, there are some institutes which do the work of management in the situations of disasters. Remedial and preventive measures. Under this point, we have first studied about first aid. What is first aid? If I consider an example, I am fallen down on a ground due to sunstroke. I was standing in a sun and suddenly I fall down. What will happen? I will not know what exactly is happening to me. So some or the other person will come and give me a support, make me sit on a chair, give me a glass of water to drink. That is the first aid. First aid means immediate help given to the victim. Victim means a patient. Let's study few preventive measures in the situation like external bleeding. External bleeding we have seen in the textbook also. A person whose leg was bleeding. So what preventive measures or remedies we can do? We can wash the wound. Apply some antiseptic and wash the wound clearly. After that, give a glass of water to a person and take the person to the doctor. Now, giving a glass of water, giving emotional support can be done in all the below situations like burns and scales, sunstrokes, snake bites, dog bites. You can give emotional support for the snake bite person, dog bite person, all types of disasters. Emotional support helps a person to recover soon. Let's study about burns and scales. Burns and scales means when a person is a victim in the fire situation, then that person may have some burns on his body. So what we can do for a help? We can wash his wounds slowly, not rapidly. We cannot do it fast because why? Already the person is suffering more. Yes, then apply a ointment which is oil free. We cannot apply the oily ointments. What about sunstroke? I told you an example of giving a glass of water, making sit on the chair or on the ground wherever the victim is comfortable. If the person is feeling vomiting, what can we do? We can turn his face towards the ground level so that he feels more comfortable. Now, snake bites and dog bites, these two situations are there such that we cannot directly give them help. We have to immediately take the person to the doctor. But before that, for a person with snake bite, we can at least tie a strip of a cloth to the upper level of the bite where the snake has given a bite so that the snake's poison which is released into the body of a person does not travel in your whole body. Yes, and what about dog bites? We have to wash the wound, apply antiseptic and then take the victim to the doctor. Now students, after revising the lesson, I will show you a few pictures. You will see few pictures on your screen and you have to find out what different types of disasters these are. So come along. Here on the screen, you can see there is a wave of seas, waves of water. What is that disaster? This is a tsunami like disaster. Let's go to the next picture. There are four different pictures on your screen now. In the first one, you can see the waves are crossing over the buildings. In the second, a hurricane into deep into the sea, into the ocean. Third one, storm. And fourth one, earthquakes. Because of earthquakes, the buildings have collapsed down. The left side picture shows you forest fire. See how horrible it looks when the forest turns into fire. And the right side picture, what does it show? It shows you an earthquake. Can you see few cracks present on the road? The cracks are resulting because of the earthquake. The shaking of earth results into cracks on the surface of the earth. Here you can see few people are taking their bags, their luggages in traveling into the water. Till where the water level is? The water level is at least to the knee level. Yes, so this is the flood. And this picture shows you the volcano. Volcano takes place on the hill. Yes, and it gives out lava. It gives out black smoke. This is the volcano. Now, in this picture, you can see few people. Yes, You can see few people in their blue color uniform. So these are the people running the institutes of disaster management. As I have explained earlier, few people who run the managements of disaster, they bring the situation into control. They take the people for the help, for the medical treatment. So these people are disaster management. This is the disaster management institute. You can see the buildings, the car. Yes, this is the disaster they are facing and the people are helping some or the other. Students, today we finish with the lesson. In the next class, we shall start with the new chapter. Thank you.